Bala Devi has enjoyed an exemplary football career over the last 17 years, but it's only in January 2020 that she's made headlines and risen to prominence on a national scale with news of a move to Rangers FC. The 30-year-old striker has earned an 18-month contract following a trial with the Glasgow club, whose women's team has gone pro this season. Indian Super League outfit Bengaluru FC helped facilitate Devi's move through their partnership with Rangers in what could be a big step forward for women's football in India. Imagine Bala Devi being in the starting 11 for a Champions League match in women's football. That's big for the country, for people to follow her and other women footballers to want to take that step, Bengaluru CEO Manda Tamane said. He and other Indian football enthusiasts have every right to be optimistic, especially with the fabled tale for the East serving as a source of encouragement in Asia. Homari Sawa inspired Japan to the Women's World Cup title in 2011, beating favourites United States in the final. As captain and key figure, she was elevated to legendary status and named FIFA Women's Player of the Year. But a significant portion of her path to success was tread on foreign shores. Ironically, it's the time spent playing in the US that she and Japan have to thank for that memorable triumph. Her quality lifted those around her as they gradually developed into a team that would be world champions. Sawa's story highlights the benefits of Asian players traveling abroad to compete at the highest level and how it can impact their national teams. Devi is in awe of Sawa's exploits and hopes she can play a similar role for Indian women's football. Homari Sawa is an icon of football in Asia, Devi told Sport360. I want to set an example and prove that Indian players can be as good as anyone. If I can do well, hopefully more girls will follow. Devi is conscious of the social stigma attached to women competing in sport, but her story is one that chips away at the misconceptions of a patriarchal society. She spent much of her childhood playing football with the boys in her neighborhood and beating them. I used to practice with my friends and boys from the village, and that is where I learned to play, she recalls. I didn't think about how good I was. I just took it as a challenge to be able to compete with or play better than the boys. Devi was fortunate to grow up in a football family that supported her dream. Her father played the game and encouraged not only his two sons, but his twin daughters to play as well. She appreciates her family's support, as many don't offer the same to girls in India, and hopes to see that change. Fortunately, she hails from the state of Manipur, where girls are largely supported in their sporting endeavors. Thanks to that backing, Devi was able to move on from the comfort of her neighborhood ground and chase her dream. After playing at her local village club, ICSA, she moved to NYTHC and represented them from the age of 12 before joining Manipur Police Sports Club in 2010. Devi has a stunning international record, scoring 52 goals in 58 appearances for India. She's also been a star in the Indian Women's League, which began in 2016, finishing as top scorer twice and scoring a record 7 hat-tricks along the way. Among her inspirations, Devi counts Olympic boxer Mary Kom and former Indian footballer Oinam Bembem Devi, who also played for Manipur Police and roomed with her as a teammate on international duty. Bala has succeeded Bembem as the national team captain, and having been named AIFF Women's Player of the Year in 2015 and 2016, has assumed her place in the Indian football landscape. I always dreamed of playing in Europe, even when playing with foreign sides in the national team. We've lost, but we've competed with them. In the last couple of years, India played the Cotiff Cup in Spain, and after facing oppositions from La Liga and other countries, she was confident she could cope at that level and carried that belief into her trials in Scotland. She's used to the cold weather in Manipur and has never had any dietary issues. However, while adjusting to life in Scotland seemed effortless for the Indian international, the paperwork involved was anything but. In order to attain the UK work permit, her representatives worked tirelessly with the Scottish club. Devi's agent, Anuj Kishlu, spoke of the difficulty to secure a work permit and credits Rangers for going all out and appealing for a special permit through the Scottish FA panel. India's national ranking is outside the mandatory top 40 for an automatic qualification, but with the support from the references in India and the efforts of the Rangers management and legal advisors, an exception was made. With a relationship forged and a precedent set, one would hope this paves the way for more Indian footballers to make the transition. There's plenty of scope in the women's game, and Tamane is understandably confident in seeing the national team compete on the world stage before their male counterparts. Everyone in India believes that the women's Indian team will play a World Cup before the men's, he says. When that day does finally arrive, Bala Devi will hope to lead the team out. For now though, she's the one lighting the way.